Hey guys, welcome back from Classic Work. I get a lot of requests out there to show me and my dad working together, and this is what my dad's done for over 40 years, is work on agricultural tractors pretty much. He cut his teeth on internationals, and that's what he grew up with. Like this tractor right here, this is a 1086. He got to see them new, you know, he got to work on them when they were new. So I've helped my dad a really long time with clutch jobs and motor jobs and these particular tractors. What we're doing right here is setting this one up to split it to put a clutch in it. This is a very common thing. Internationals have ceramic clutches in them, and if you ride the clutch any at all, you'll burn them out. So this is a international splitting stand, and I'm going to show you how to use it.
So what Dad's doing over there is these frame rail bolts right here. He's taking the bottom ones out here. Mounting plates on this rail that will hang on the stand. That's what he's doing right now. I'll catch this side when he gets done. These stands are pretty cool. These are actually international stands. They're designed to do this. So, something you don't see every day. I cut my teeth on doing stuff like this, so helping my dad out when I was really young. So it's second nature to me, but I've had a lot of people ask about them, so just showing you. I got the floor pan out.
You gotta get them bolts out. Right there. So the trick to that is one of these. Got to be just the right length with a wobble head on it. Wobble extension. Do I, Daddy?
Oh, you want something to drive it with?
I'll get something. Yeah, they are.
plate up.
Here we got
okay. Sure.
What's that fell out? Springs?
Something. Yeah, that was a piece of a spring.
Trying the hood, I think.
Don't look bad.
Turn it over. Springs are tore up.
Yep. Clutch a shot.
It's slipping.
The pads still look okay. A little burnt.
Yeah, they burnt.
Ugh.
That's why I wouldn't release those springs were hanging up.
Hanging up. I got you.
I picture that.
Yeah.
Probably don't look that bad.
No, I don't. Yeah, that ain't supposed to happen. Damn, it's been spinning, hasn't it?
It's kind of locked up a little bit.
Well, I mean, you gonna be able to put another bearing in there?
Yeah, I think so.
Really? Wow, that ain't worth a damn.
Yeah, take a picture of this. That's why it wouldn't shift.
Why it wouldn't shift?
Come here. The springs were running in the first place.
Oh, really? That's what it was doing?
Wouldn't release.
Huh. That's interesting. Huh. So, he's going to need a IPTO shaft.
Clutch and pressure plate.
Clutch and pressure plate and throw out bearing shot. All right. 10-4.
You got to take the battery out and get all that shit out.
Yep.
And the step.
All right. Let me bring y'all back up to speed now. So Dad's got the flywheel remounted on there. This one here looked good enough that didn't need any turning done. There's a step in there, but there's no big cracks or anything like that in it, so it should be ready to go. So got a brand new clutch. This one here is ceramic. Most internationals are. Got a brand new IPTO shaft, which is up under here. You can't see it. And Dad's got the pressure plate right here behind. So we'll line it up from this way. That way we don't have to have a lineup tool to line it up here with the pilot bearing. So kind of old school way of getting all that junk lined up. New throwout bearing. You do have to pull the, what do you call that shaft, Daddy?
The release fork shaft.
It has to come out from this side right here. You pull that out. You have to take a step off and everything. But yeah, so she's brand new. All up under the hood on that side towards the transmission. So we're gonna roll this dude back together and get her back puffing smoke again.
just to show you what we're dealing with here. You see the daylight through there, through the crack. The trick to it is, a lot of times, is getting your gap lined up right. You can see that where the crack's wider at the bottom than it is up at the top. A lot of times you can judge that by going up and down with your combination of your stand and your jack, but in this case, she's wanting to stay low. I don't know why. So you always read it by the pressure plate. So what Dad's doing is he's going up through the dust cover there and bolting the pressure plate to the flywheel. How many bolts is it, Dad? Is it 8?
12.
There's a bunch of them.
3/8.
Mm-hmm. And that is the nastiest place on this entire tractor. Ask me how I know. That's something about that clutch dust and oil. So we're gonna let him start them bolts, and then we'll finish pulling this dude together. Isn't that right, Daddy?
Right.
All right. Yeah. See, ain't nothing to it. Roll one of these back together. This is actually one of the easier ones that I've seen go back together. Leave it to the camera to get the tractor spooked. Because I'm going to tell you, we fought some, hadn't we, Dad? Pretty bad?
Yes, sir.
What would you say is the hardest tractor to stab? Would you say?
I think a John Dreere permaclutch.
Permaclutch? That would be like a
4440,
4430. 30, gotcha. Wet clutch.
Because
you can't turn the motor, can you, and make the clutch turn? Because it's got to have hydraulic pressure to turn, doesn't it?
Right, it's just all the discs are free in there.
Right.
The hubs are.
So you pretty much got to get lucky then, huh?
Yeah, you
got to
get her lined up just right.
Just right, I got you. But yeah, International's not bad. Ford is probably the easiest. I've never seen a tractor stab easier than a Ford. Would you agree with that, Daddy? That's pretty cool though. But yeah, we'll catch you up. The biggest thing about these is don't force them together. You'll bust something or something might line up. I like your crack went together, Daddy.
Okay.
Alright, I'll tighten this side up a little bit. That bolt's still a little tough. I guess it's gonna be alright if you've got everything started.
It's a little tough coming apart.
Some of them just like that?
Yes, sir.
All right. So I'll get the two. There's two behind the frame right here on the bottom. All right. Set y'all back up.
Over there, Danny.
What,
socket?
Just wrench.
Yeah.
Onto
the tractor.
All right, thank you.
It's air
conditioner.
Right in there. What is it,
pie? Yeah, air conditioner.
We didn't have one in between there, did we?
In between where?
The cable or nothing. I don't see that.
No, I didn't see anything on my side. I don't think it would have went. Who passed a, what was it? It was some line one time. Things going a lot easier than it was.
Yeah, it was hard. Line top right.
Yeah, it ain't the best. I'll bring y'all up speed real quick here. Other than me screwing up the air conditioner line, I didn't take it off. Dad did. So apparently that goes on the inside. But yeah, we got her back together there. Starting to put the linkage back on, hook up fuel filters and all that jazz. Dad's got all the bolts tightened in the flywheel.
So rest of it was pretty much small stuff and getting the hood back on. But you're going to test it, ain't you, Dad, before you put the hood back on?
Yes, sir.
All right. So hopefully I'll be back around that time when he gets back. And, yeah, just get after it.